shining day. He brings some sunshine in. He's thumb out his Bible in his other hand, telling folks how to reach.
But I still like to listen to the radio. They say rock and roll is wrong, we'll give you one more chance. I say I feel so good, I gotta get up and dance. Woo! I know what's right, I know what's wrong, I don't confuse it. And all I wanna know is why should the devil have all the good music? I ain't knocking the hymns. Just give me a song that has a beat. I ain't knocking the hymns. Just give me a song that moves my feet. I don't like none of those funeral marches.
And part of the sharing and the hospitality that you read in the Bible focuses around this rather mystical substance that we call bread. And bread in the Bible has a mysticism and a spiritual significance in most of its references. Jesus took bread and broke it, gave it to his disciples and said, every time you eat this bread, you remember my death. Be in this festival for Jesus next week, there'll be thousands of people, many of them hungry people, hungry not for this bread, but for the true bread, which has come down from heaven. Now it's possible for men and women to be hungry and never find food, and so they die. And all around us there are people who are hungry for God, but they may never find the true bread. And the festival for Jesus and everything that we seek to do is an opportunity of holding out the bread and saying, this is the true bread. Come, take, eat.
And we're going to have a meeting and a festival on Tower Hill, right here. And we want you to know that these things are going to happen, because if you're not here next Thursday, you'll just kick yourself. 5 o'clock, come here after work and enjoy some good music. Enjoy some happy people.